Добрый день, уважаемые.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, dear experts, dear guests of the forum. We start our discussion, our section on the topic, the street, a transit zone or a social place. Allow me to introduce our participants of the section. Pyotr Birikov, Deputy Mayor of Moscow for Housing, Utilities and Amenities in the Moscow government. Alexei Nemiruk, head of the Trade Department and Services of the Moscow. Tatiana Guk, Deputy Chairman of the Committee for Architecture and Urban Planning of Moscow. Alexei Muratov, partner at Strelka KB. Boris Pasternak, Chief Architect of the Urban History Studies. Alexander Polikov, Deputy Head of Moscow Traffic Control Center. Martin Reinkanau, Landscape Architect, Managing Partner of Topotec 1, Germany. Olga Aksakova, Head Partner of Bureau Moscow. And first line expert, Terje Nipan, Senior Counselor for Directorate for Cultural Heritage, Norway. One of the key aims of the development of Moscow, as given in the program Moscow City Comfortable for Life, I will quote, is the creation of a comfortable and high quality environment, which is adjusted, first of all, for the citizens of the city. And this adjustment, this comfort for the citizens, is a key word in the Moscow Street program. Street is a most important space in public, streets make up 12% of the area of the capital within the border of the Moscow Ring Road. And this tells us that the streets of Moscow are the key moment of the activity of the city, and they should be accessible, comfortable, convenient for citizens. They should be recognizable, significant in the public space. And currently, the government of Moscow has launched an unprecedented program on the municipal improvement of the city. It is called My Street because the streets should become the space for citizens adjusted to the inhabitants of the city for their needs. And up until 2019, there should be improvement carried out for 3,000 streets, and that's unprecedented amount. And as it seems to me, nowhere in the world can we find such a large-scale programs. The problems requiring priority solutions within the framework of this program, Moscow Cities, include the overcoming of disbalance between different types of transportation and between the pedestrian and car movement, the enhances of safety on the streets, the recognizability of the streets, the provision of comfort at being in the open air during various times of the day and seasons, and the improvement of park spaces. And the My Street program is the largest program for municipal improvement in the history of our city. And in such a large-scale megalopolis as Moscow, such programs were not carried out for three decades since 1980, during the preparation of the capital for the Olympic Games events. Therefore, the scale of the transformation provided for the development of the city at such a new contemporary scale also provides for the development of brand new approaches and methods and solutions in municipal improvement. And these approaches should not only meet the standards of international practice, but also the specificity of Moscow, its historic character, its identity, this economic development specificity, political role of the capital as well. And these approaches should be most efficient considering the conditions of the present day. And that's what we're going to talk about during our session. And the first participant that I would like to give the floor to is Pyotr Berikov, Deputy Mayor of Moscow for Housing, Utilities and Amenities in the Moscow government. So please, Mr. Berikov, you have the floor. Good afternoon, dear participants of the session, dear colleagues. First of all, I would like to tell you about a special importance of improvement in Moscow, and this topic is quite popular. And today I would like to emphasize certain terms and certain solutions that we implement. Improvement, well, this term is used as was used as a narrow term, meaning the reality of the present day. There is construction of the new city, and urban development sector is dealing with that. Renovation and restoration of memorials, valuable memorials, and the memorial department is working with that, and the reconstruction of everything constructed in the city. There's also something that we have. So Moscow is constantly renovated and restored. And during 2015, we've asphalted over 14,000 square meters. And we've planted 30,000 trees. And also, we've renovated 943 facades and established 262 cable lines. So all this work is improvement. And as we are in the urban forum now, I would like to say that in my point of view, everything that contemporary urbanism is dealing with, all excluding contemporary construction and architectural restoration, it is solved by the improvement means. And from my point of view, urbanism, I would like to emphasize urbanism, but not city building policy in Moscow, was something that Mr. Sobyanin launched. This approach to improvement has changed. And during the 1990s to 2000s, Moscow was searching for new construction platforms and constructed new buildings. Then, beginning from 2010, we paid attention to something that is not bought or sold, but makes the essence of city organism, the common good. These are engineering networks, social infrastructure, but first and foremost, those are public places, the main essence of the city. And the term social space was something that we got when Mr. Sobyanin started working. And it was something new for us, and this term public space was not defined by the city regulations, and we understood different points on that, from the first floors of public buildings to general roads, roads of general use. Moscow required this model space, something that could become the face of the new urban policy. And in 2011-2014, parks and pedestrian zones became such a phase. And we all know this story, we remember it, and I won't talk in details about that. But I'd like to know that work on the improvement of the parks is not stopped, it is continued, and now we've improved 400 parks. And comparing with 2010, we have absolutely new 240 parks and park zones. And for the first time in the history of Moscow, on the offer of the Moscow people, we've launched a program, Park at the Place of Living. And during the recent 3 years, we've established 161 of such parks. And the new parks from the center of the city has went to the periphery of the city, to the place of living of our population. And at the same time, urbanists could not had to notice that in 2014-2015, the streets gained general attention. The streets are changed, reconstructed, they are written about, they become the face of contemporary Moscow. And in the present year, we've renovated 50 streets and squares of Moscow, and from 23 streets. Therefore, I would like to concentrate on the program My Street as a new information sphere that we have on our conscience. And an active part in the improvement was taken by the companies and organizations that renovated the territories, improved the facades of their buildings and their territories. So I would like to emphasize that organizations and the companies were quite active in this renovation process. And at the same time, now hundreds of enterprises, by the decision of mayor, were thanked. We've sent them letters. Moscow of 2010 was a city where this model was a history. And scientific progress was the main idea then, and the streets were accommodated for the transport. And the more cars were going along the streets, the better we are developing. That was the general idea. And we know the consequences. We have come up to transportation collapse. And I would like to remind that up until 2010, the problem was solved by an industrial way, taking away the traffic lights, taking away the passages, and taking away the green areas. My Street program is a change of urbanist ideology. And here are the main tasks to make streets recognizable, accessible, safe, or create comfortable conditions for having a rest, overcoming the disbalance between pedestrian, cycle, and car movement, and to improve the park space. These are the goals. So from the street for the car, we've shifted to the street for the man. And for the street for transportation means to the public space street. And here we have comfort, recognizability, lighting, improving the pedestrian areas, new covers, bicycle lines, small architectural forms. Everything of that is something that Moscovites are familiar with, and they approve this strategy. And many capitals have it, but what is different is that we introduce it in a systematic way, in a complex way. Our streets are transformed. And considering the urbanism, street is not a physical space, but the people who are on it. How should we involve the transformation of Moscow streets? For us, it's not a theoretical, but a practical issue. We cannot talk about unexpected weakness of Moscow territorial communities if we talk about some public hearings which are inefficient. And in this issue, we've taken most advanced social technologies, namely the internet, and the program My Street is implemented together with the citizens with the use of active citizen project. And the main stages of the implementation, including the polling system and the active citizen portal. First of all, you should choose what should be done in different types of streets, then what streets are to renovate, and what element of improvement should be chosen. And in 2015, 890,000 Moscovites took part in the polls. And as experts say, but I think we understand it ourselves, is quite a high result. And just imagine, if we talk about our population, that's one-tenth of the population. And experts now are saying that if something is discussed, then it's enough to have 1% of participation in this issue. And these figures stand for themselves. They say that this topic is quite in demand among citizens. And in short, about the logics of the program. Well, Moscow is a city with radial concentric planning, and the center of the city has more of a workload of the transport and wear off more quickly. And after that, we have main lines, because the majority of people use them, and the implementation of the program allowed us to improve 232 kilometers of the streets, including 116 kilometers renovated in 2015. And it should be noted that we organize these municipal improvement works not only in the center of the city, but all across the city. And now about what happens to each street. First of all, we try to attain a balance of interest between pedestrian, cycler, and car owner. And it means that we decrease the space for cars that were dominating, but we don't lose the mobility. And according to the results of our work, the mobility of transport did not deteriorate, but somehow even increased, and at the same time, illegal parking plots has suffered, but that would be the result in any way. And as we know, this was one of the reasons of problem for transportation movement, and we had to do something to deal with it. A special topic, dear colleagues, is the restoration of bicycle movement in Moscow, and that's one of the results of the Moscow Urban Forum. Once again, we started using bicycles due to the idea of Jan Gehl, but it was used to be a Moscow tradition. We remember Lev Tolstoy that was cycling on this territory where we hold our forum, or, for example, Mayakovsky cycling across the Red Square, and he brought Renault car from Paris to his friend Lila Brick, but he brought a bicycle for himself, and we had to restore the bicycle movement area in Moscow. This work is not finished, but we have some good preliminary results. 242 kilometers across Moscow is the length of these bicycle roads, but now we have priority in our pedestrians, and in the center of the city, we started organizing luxurious pedestrian spaces. I'm talking about trees, about lighting, about the coverage. And, well, granite walls are not only some long-term cover, but the quality of the pedestrian area is quite important for the symbolic hierarchy of the street. So compare the building covered with granite, or the typical panel house of a five-story building, or the building which we now create. So that's the same about the coverings of the streets. When the street has granite cover, then it looks different. And it should be emphasized that this program is not only a social program, but a technical innovation as well. And according to the order of Mr. Sabianin, after the street is renovated, there is a moratorium in place to organize works during 5 years, excluding some emergency cases. During 5 years, no works should be carried out on this street, for example, digging works, only in case of emergency, and then the emergency is the responsibility of the organization that carries out this renovation. So now we have a comprehensive renovation of the streets, considering all the engineering systems that deals with full transformation of electric networks, and we've declined this row of wires over our heads, and we shifted them to the underground cables. We change engineering communications as well. So Moscow today is a unique Russian region that during the 5 years, there was a decline in the wearing off of the networks of engineering communal infrastructure. And due to the sanation of this network, the wear off of the networks has not only just decreased by 2.5%, but on the whole in the Russian Federation it has grown by 4.7%, you see. And I'd like to show you the program in figures. So above the indicators that I've already mentioned, I was talking also about the improvement of 3,300 yards, including nearly 400 yards improved for the citizens of these renovated streets. And we have a lot of benches, over 10,000. We have special lighting that symbolize the historic image of Moscow. And we've also heard today the figure that Moscow did it in the 80s. And I would like to say that even in 1980, we didn't have such a large-scale operation on the renovation of the streets. And this was done for the first time during the whole history of the city of Moscow. And in conclusion, a few words about our plans. The mayor adopted the concept of development of public recreation spaces within the framework of the implementation of the city program for the next 3 years. And within this concept, we will continue our comprehensive development of recreational facilities in the city. And now we are working on 27 public areas that are divided into 6 groups. And we have defined key indicators for future development. And as a result of the events, by 2018, we will have just 3 types of space unfinished. For example, industrial territories, some railways, and future development territories. And in 2016, we plan to focus on 11 key public recreational spaces. We plan to improve 9 parks of culture and rest, 84 streets, and 60% of Sadovaya Ring, internal part of Boulevard Ring, and the establishment of 49 parks on the living places, 11 incoming groups, 9 recreation zones with water, 7 zones without water, 6 embankments, and other top priority projects. And in order to develop this space, we will develop a number of key instruments that will and define the future development of the whole recreational infrastructure. And such instruments are United Information System of Recreational Areas, the standard for renovation of such groups of objects, the strategy of development of public spaces, and a certain instrument of estimation of the quality of the infrastructure of quality, the index of the Moscovite. And as an during the implementation of this program, we will enhance safety on the roads and 100% of improvement of key territories and the provision of the citizens with infrastructure, necessary infrastructure. Thank you. Thank you very much, Petro Pavlovich. I would like to ask you one short question. In 2015, the program has reached significant success, implemented quite a number of projects, and a number of projects is already planned. So could you tell me what are the basic principles of carrying out the program in the next years? Will they remain as in 2015, or will there be some changes? What are the prospects of conceptual development of the program? Well, conceptual development is the following. What we've worked upon during the previous years and what was approved by the Moscovites is something that we are going to save. But further on, during the implementation of the program, we've seen how enthusiastic were Moscovites involved in the implementation of the program and what they were hindering at. And I told you that today we've seen 27 types of various recreational places creating comfort for Moscovites. And here we will work on models of the management of such spaces, the models for creating comfort. And for sure, without Moscovites, without ideological work, without experience, a wonderful experience of our foreign colleagues, we can't achieve any significant results in this program. And the most important thing is that Moscovites wanted to see something on some or other street, then everything will be implemented, everything will be in place, and in the next 3 years, the program will not stably move forward, but also will be actively developing. Thank you very much, Peter. And now I'd like to give the floor to the following speaker, that's Alexei Muratov, Strelka KB partner.
Uh, Good afternoon, esteemed guests. Thank you very much, Daria, for such a detailed introduction of my program. It will allow me to stick to definite details and as well as the topic of the forum is flexible management practices. I would like to deal about one of such practices in the context of my work. We cooperate with the complex of urban economy and we help them to implement this project. And one of the tools which is called the standard of provision of amenities for street spaces is an innovation and flexible tool of management because unlike ordinary standards, norms and other documents, this one is having the recommendation character and is being a kind of manual in terms of measures aimed at the establishment of qualitative environment, because usually a lot of standards are dealing with the issues of sanitary quality and so on and so forth. And within the framework of this standard, we need to stipulate four books. Now two are already in the first edition, and I would like to dwell upon the book number one, which is called Spatial Code, and which provides four main provisions to the establishment of the program My Street in the Nearest Future. The first and the main concept issue is what's good and what's bad, what we call qualitative environment. And we answer this question using the pyramid of Maslow as the basis, because his methodology has become the part of the management theory and is used in urban studies as well. The pyramid has three levels: the demands, basic demands, social demands, individual demands, and these three levels of demands are complied with the criteria of environment quality, which we use as a landmark to devise our manual and recommendations. Thus, we have three basic criteria. These are safety, environmental issue, and comfortability. And comfortability implies for climate, visual, sound, mobility, comfort, issues of accessibility, and simplicity of use. There is another criteria connected with social demands, that the criteria of identity. And this criteria is connected with the peculiar traits of the place, social peculiar traits and physical peculiar traits, and it's oriented at the accountability of users, the city dwellers of Moscow. And the highest criteria is the diversity criterion, which is dealing with the central status places. And now we have been talking about this system of improvement of Moscow city environment, and it had several waves. And the program My Street is an unprecedented program, but once in 30, 50 years, but we faced such waves. And one of the most famous waves happened after the fire of 1812, and after that commission started to resurrect the city. After that we had the wave in the middle of the 19th century, and after that we had this wave dedicated to the 300 year anniversary of the Romanov house, and so on and so forth. What's the difference of My Street program? It is not accompanied by massive new construction. We are talking about enhancement of existing infrastructure, and that's why first and foremost we need to understand what kind of environment it is and what measures to improve it are needed. This issue leads us to the issue of common features and traits of Moscow streets, which on the one hand can help us to define common measures and to answer the question whether we can use the guidelines and manuals textbooks which have been published in many cities of the world, New York, Singapore, London, and many others. Well, we can't, because Moscow, in terms of the streets, is quite a unique city. We can point out the low density of a street network and bad connectivity. Our intersections are located at the distance of 300 meters in the center and 500 meters in the periphery, and in European cities the difference is up to 50-180 meters, and the trend of expansion of streets is also revealed in Moscow. 77% of streets in Moscow are wider than 20 meters, and 20 meters is a normal breadth of a European street, and 37% of Moscow streets are wider than 40 meters, and 40 meter is a normal size for the highway. On the one hand, this breadth calls forward these issues. We have a lot of free spaces, especially in the periphery. What are we to do with them, the space between the highway and the residential area? We have excessive breadth of lanes. We know that they account approximately for 4.5 meters when we have the standard up to 3.75 meters. And if we have a look at American theory, they recommend 3 meters, 3.3. These are normal indicators, so we have excessive breadth of the lane. These excessive breadth still leads to compressed pedestrian zones, the zones which can be used by pedestrians. But if we have a look at central streets, then 20-30% of their territory are for the pedestrians. Still, it used to be like that. But all other territory is for the automobiles. As a result, we have low automobile density and pedestrian density, so it means that they are not used efficiently and they have a hybrid character, because the most active streets from the point of view of car flow are the most active for the pedestrians as well. And the low density also is very peculiar trait of Moscow streets. And some characteristics connected to ecology and climate, season, continental climate, high number of precipitations, and humidity, high humidity. And also, a lot of citizens of Moscow live in the zone of sound discomfort. And we also have the effect of the heat island when the temperature in the center is higher than in the suburbs and in the region. And these are the proof of the fact that the deepness of issues is that to make the city comfortable both for pedestrians and drivers is almost impossible, and correspondingly we come to the art of possibilities, which implies delayering of Moscow streets and defining minimum and maximum number of measures which are to be implemented. And we have devised a classification using these twin nature of Moscow streets, as they are the, on the one hand, public space platform and traffic road on the other one. We've used two parameters, the first one the geometric parameter, and the second one is the efficiency of use, which demonstrates priorities of use of the street both for automobiles and pedestrians. And here you see the classification in terms of geometry indicators, and the figures are the following. The breadth of non-transport space is at the top on the x-axis, and we see the distribution, and they are divided into three parts: downtown, middle zone, and periphery. And the efficiency of use is on the one hand calculated due to the index of pedestrian activity, and it involves six criteria. And these criteria stipulate the efficiency and intensity of pedestrian activeness, and we have the index of transport activity, and that thanks to Mr. Blimkin and his department for providing us with this data. And comparing geometric indicators and the intensive efficiency of use, we have the topology of Moscow streets, and they are very well distributed in different zones of the city. We have four types: on periphery, two in the middle zone, and four types in the center of Moscow. And for each type, we stipulate problems and crucial approaches. And as an example, that's the 1P type, the most intensively used streets of Moscow. And these are inner city highways, and they're wide, approximately 96 meters, and 71 meter is the breadth of non-transport space. And there is the low level of transport security. They have the majority of accidents and car accidents happening, and pedestrians are the part of those accidents in half of cases. This is the high level of sound and pollution, non-used free open spaces, low level of comfort, and low connectivity of two parts of the streets. And so we have recommendations for different Moscow addresses, approximately 3,000 addresses. And we have recommendations for pedestrian security, for example, a number of ground increasing the number of ground overpasses to increase comfort. We recommend to establish different leisure zones, take into account the intensity of pedestrian flows, and we have a number of measures which can be discussed. And let us imagine another story, 1C story, the most narrow and calm city streets. Their breadth is not more than 15 meters, and the major issue problems are the other ones. That's the first and foremost the effect of the heat island due to the lack of greenery and absorbing parts of land, and the limited breadth of pedestrian parts, and limited opportunities for organization of parking lots. And so we recommend to organize the broad pedestrian zones and an opportunity for linear parking at least on the one part of the street for residents of the district. So there is a list of recommendations, and using them we start devising our next books of standards. The first one will be dedicated to details. These recommendations will be devised as planning, constructive solutions, and plans. And another, the second book is dedicated to implementation of these measures in practice, and it will be involving estimates of the recommendations involved using the criteria I've been mentioning at the beginning of my presentation. And I hope that together with the esteemed experts, we will be able to discuss these books by the end of the year when they are ready. Thank you, Alexei.
And before you take your seat, I would like to ask you a small question. So you were talking about methodological recommendations, about theoretical filling of this program, My Street, but did you take part in specific projects that were implemented in the streets of Moscow this year? Well, near Детский мир, we've developed a project jointly with our subcontractors, our partners, under the guidance of the city economy department. And it seems to me that this theoretical part is quite important here, because over 3,000 streets should be covered by the program, and it's important to have a systematic and comprehensive approach. And in order to attain that, we should form the recommendations basis, the idea basis, the details, the elements. So it's important work, and it's wonderful that it's carried out, because it shows the intention to make all these events sensible within a certain united framework. Well, for sure, I think we all agree with that, that the systematic approach is quite a need. And I would like to shift to a short discussion and to get an overview. And I would like to ask Mr. Martin Reagan, could you tell me, is Moscow program corresponding to the world trends, and should it correspond to the world trends?
Yeah, it does. And well, first of all, I would like to congratulate the city as much as Strelka also for the already visible results that that you can see. I mean, there is no. I mean, the global got the world got very diversified. So I think that the discussions happen on many levels. I think probably it's the most ambitious program that I know from any city around the world. I would say, what is a good thing.
Okay, thank you. Спасибо большое.
Thank you very much. And could you tell me, are there some peculiarities that you would like to note in this program, in what's happening, because you are the observer of this program today?
So the Strelka is really immense and very professional. I must admit that I don't know from any other city such a base work. Normally, cities start without this kind of very deep analytical things. I mean, just looking at your city, the fascination is obviously the layers, and the, and maybe one thing that is unusual from a European perspective is the big jump in scale. So these beautiful, huge, monumental streets that you have here are unique. That can be very, very, very interesting and an astonishing space experience. And how to get these streets that were meant in the end for cars, how to get them to become streets as much for cars as for pedestrians, is quite an interesting task, I would say, and pretty special in the case of Moscow.
Thank you very much. It's very pleasant to hear such words, and I would like Boris Pasternak to comment on this issue as well. Please tell us, how do you see the specificity of Moscow's streets? How should they be taken into account carrying out the improvement work, and to what extent is it done? Well, for me, it is of principal importance to maintain the historic potential of Moscow Old Street and find out the historic value of the surrounding construction, as we know that along with the construction works within the framework of these works, we carry out the work on facades, and this also covers valuable buildings and the buildings that could be valuable. And in this account, I think it's important for me to program this activity in order to keep and at the same time to give these facades the initial image, to restore them. I think it's dealing with the major details, with plastery, and we know that within the framework of the renovation, it's quite done in an operative way. Some programs require a long-term detailization, and for me, you can't always do them. It was at the first stages of this program, but now I think that the process is becoming more and more systematic, and it seems to me that taking into account the types and the style of the streets, it's important to pay attention to the policy of the first floors, of the ground floors, not only to their functionality, not only to the city pressure on such restoration, but also to the aesthetics and to the stylistic correspondence of the such houses. For example, when we have plastic doors in modern buildings, when the painting of the ground floors stays out of the general image of the building, it's very important to give the users of these buildings, to make them the participants of the program. They should understand the value of the style, of this style requirements to the world that we see in front of our eyes. And it seems to me that that's a gift to the city users, but they should be more actively involved. And we should use the method of albums, for example, characteristic stylish solutions. We should give the proposals that should be used in such a city practice. Thank you very much. And I would like to ask to comment on this point, Tatiana Gu. That's the question to you, because that's quite a discussive issue. To what extent should be we involved to the authentic to the authentic city structure? Should we offer the replicas of the lanterns, for example? And to what extent should we observe the image of the epoch of the architecture of the architectural space, or should we involve some modern objects? Well, the question is very interesting, and I'd like to answer it from the other point of view. In order to estimate the value of what we have in the city, first of all, we should clean the city from this visual garbage that we sometimes have. And all my colleagues present here remember Moscow 3 years ago, when there was a lot of advertising constructions, advertising on the facades and everything of that. And now, when we have come to a situation when we finally saw that we have quality historic area with which we should work, and the result will be attained in a case when, as Peter told, when we'll have citizens involved in this process, as well as the business community that can be attracted on the mass scale, then the steps taken by the city, and I will give you a small example about the advertising, the typical solutions that were published at Moscow architectural website, and there was quite a lot of illustrations that allowed us to achieve the results. And that is the work that gives effect at once. And after that comes the analysis of the area that we've cleaned up and that we can see. And only after that, with careful treatment, we can talk about future steps. And what happens within the framework of My Street project? I think that the approaches differ, and there are different examples in the city. And as a citizen, not as an official, I would like to comment on the topic. I live in the Southern District, and I daily go along Kashirska Road. So, Petr, I would like to thank you because it's some kind of a festival when you see the blocks, not the blocks, but the granite board, which create, well, some kind of a festival impression, you know. So, and it is done quite simply. That's a high quality solution, quite a simple and elegant, and it gives a wonderful visual effect. Lawns, lanterns, lack of wires hanging over our heads, and that was what Petr was talking about. When there's no this visual pollution, that's a wonderful effect. I can't say that's some kind of a super historic solution. It's quite simple, but it's high quality solution. We have these zones of stops, and the person going along the street, he understands where he can take public transport. Should he be attentive in this place or not? Here he has equipped places for rest, and everything is done identically throughout this main line by the architectural identical forms, and this creates an image of this specific territory. And this year we are talking about Triumph Square, and so. But not talking about my point of view as an architect, because we can say in one context, in another context, whether everything was achieved or not. Well, we didn't have the square before. What did people do there? Well, the cars and people were going there, and that's all. But now people spend time there. They meet each other there. They can sit near the subway station. And there was a lot of discussion. I won't go into details, but that's a contemporary, high-quality solution, which, according to the polls, over 80% of people say that this should have been done. And there are also contextual solutions, and Moscow, as they say, is one of a few European cities that saved its architecture, Zamoskvoretsky, Pyatnitska, Ordynka, and everything else. Well, to maintain the historic face of Moscow, it's something that we should do. And here you should be quite delicate and quite attentive, and you should choose the material for the facade solutions, for the covers. So you should work with green areas. And we're doing it. So that's the most precious that should be, retain the Moscow face and make Moscow attractive for tourists, for people to come and see what does Moscow look like. Thank you very much. And continuing this thought about comfortable Moscow, both for citizens and for tourists, I would like to recall words of Alexei, that one of the peculiarities of Moscow is its transport specificity, wide streets, noise pollution, and so on, and the arising problems. And I would like to ask Alexander Polyakov, could you please tell us what measures to regulate this issue to make Moscow more attractive for pedestrians, for cyclists, were taken or are planned to be taken? Well, here we can lay emphasis on the successes we already have, the pedestrian zone, the first calm movement zone, Pushchina Street, and that's the interaction with the housing sector as well. And if we take the question all in all, then how does the city look like? Well, the urbanists give the answer. The city looks how the streets look, whether the streets are safe or not. So the street is the guide, the face of the city. And here, Peter told us that the streets are not just streets, but a road network that was created in the 1980s. But this city, should they be as a transit or as a road? Well, in the streets, the transit should be minimal, while the roads, they are for the movement, and then transit movement should take place. And if we talk about from the historic point of view, well, Tverskaya Street, and after that, the Leningrad Highway, well, there was a trade with Tver and with Leningrad, and then Leningrad Highway appeared. And if we take Bachaya Dmitrovka, then that was a street where the shopping networks were installed. So, and for example, the port and the Volga is not just actively working right now, but the program My Street is just finishing the logic development of the street and takes it to the street communication. And as for calm movement zones, there are such things like safety boards, and they've taken the decision at direct lines with a limitation of speed. The line should be extended to 325 meters, and this can improve the pedestrian area. And as for the environment, the environmental department told us that this trend on the deterioration of the transportation system has stopped. And this year they published a report on positive results. So there are certain developments. There are things to work upon. We have cycling ways. But it should be noted that the streets should be developed on the logic of life. And this work regarding the fact that the streets should have less transit, and they should be divided from the roads with transit movement. So this work has already started, and it has some positive developments already. Thank you very much. And could you please tell me, so we've already mentioned that all the interests of transportation groups should be taken into account, cyclists, pedestrians, cars, and it can be difficult if we consider the development of the streets when all of these three groups are present. So have you faced any conflicts that arose by the actual program of improvement, and how were these conflicts solved? So there must be a comprehensive approach here, and it's obvious that this internet programs active citizen is actively used, and Moscovites use it a lot, and we have a lot of ideas. Well, conflicts may arise not to the, according to the fact whether the solution is good or bad, but the thing is that a lot of changes go at the same time, and Moscovites sometimes can't adapt to the changes. But many people are actively involved in the poll, in the polls, and therefore I think it's something that we have.
Thank you very much. I welcome such an approach taking into account the interests of end users, but I think besides such voting of citizens, we need to have some constant criteria to estimate the development of the transport situation. I would like to ask Mr. Blimkin to comment on the development of the transport system. I would like to come back to the name of our panel, transit zone or public space. And the issue is that today we face the problem which has been the issue of discussion of our foreign partners even before all the speakers of this panel were born. Maybe we, together with Peter Pavlovich, were already living, but still we were very young. So, talking about the road network in the American documents of 1940s, it was stipulated that street is not the road, road is not the street, street is the element of public space, and road is separated from the social structure. So that's why the road, for example, is in the name of the part of the third ring road. And we can consider it a highway, a third ring road, but in the classification of the urban expert, it's the street. People live there, and it's a principal issue, principal problem we will be facing in the run of dozens of years. What can we do with Sadova ring? it's the living urban street, but at the same time, it's the element of the road network. And we cannot unload it in terms of traffic because physically we can't do it. So what can we do in this regard? We can make some amendments or transformations, which are quite urgent. But we have such highways in the city which have 17 lanes. So where can we redirect the traffic which used to use those lanes if we transform the zone? So it's quite a simple thing. It's very good to consider the city street or boulevard and to be proud of having ground overpasses there. But for example, we have approximately 500 kilometers of autoroutes and parts of Rublevka and Kashirka can become the part of this classification. And I can say that we've named the figure that the street accounts for 12% of city territory, but these 12% are 12% from the point of view of communal service, together with greenery, pedestrians, ways. Robert Ravelli, a friend of mine, took part in the previous session, and he had 33% of such streets in his city. And so I started comparing what is street, what is not, whether we have a lot of ground overpasses or not. But if in Europe, if a driver needs to go far away, he won't use the street, he will use the highway. But it's impossible to do here, and it's very difficult to tackle this issue, because it's no one will decide to demolish 20% of the territory of Moscow. It's impossible. That's why the policy is the art of possibility. Everything which has been done by my friends in Strelka, the detailed classification, it's not the issue of theory, it's the issue of practice. These things which have been adopted by the foreign urban development practice, and a lot of manuals were translated. So those theoretical knowledges yielded their practical results, and I'm very happy that we've launched this project together with my friends from Strelka, and that we will be able to implement it in practice. And for example, it was a horror when in Mesnitska Street we had such a narrow pedestrian zone and students didn't have any opportunity to walk along the street. And now my windows are facing Mesnitska Street and we have a very wide pedestrian zone. And I think it's quite an achievement. Thank you. Thank you very much. We have Olga Alexahova, the Triumph Square author, and I think one of the challenges of the project is that the Triumph Square is in the center of huge highway, in the center of Sadovaya Rin. Were there any complications in connection with that? How do we combine social space and the highway?
Well, first of all, I would like to get back to the specificity of Moscow and its streets. We should not forget that we're dealing with a city where 20 years ago there were just three cafes, and all our urban efforts and improvement efforts. Why this program is so massive? Because we're dealing with such a situation that we got the Soviet city of parades and meetings. But now have a look at the changes both in the mentality and in the city itself that we observe. And in 1989, a guest from France came to visit me, and I lived in the 25-story building. So she took out, she got out of the window and read, went to sit at the grass and read a book. And quite a crowd gathered to look at her. And that was something unpredictable for a person to sit there. And what we observe today during summers or during winters, Moscow has somehow become a city that is going to the streets, and the changes, the changes of improvement, that's a question of millimeters. And I've observed the Penninska Street, where I went with two of my children that were arguing, and I was just pushing there and holding them in two of my hands and pushing them away. And we could go along the street and did not obstruct the movement along the street. So there is a change in the speed of movement along the facade. So finally, you see the facades that you've never noticed before going through narrow pavements. And it's important for you to get through all the pedestrians that are going along the street. So we've seen that at Triumph Square, when the square was open and it was a September morning, and we've seen the faces. So we can argue about the aspects of the square, but we saw the faces of people, and people were smiling on the square. So the improvement of this happiness, the raising of level of happiness for the square meter, that's the main success of the improvement of this project that we now observe. The, everything else are details. But it's important to create, to move from transit to the place of resting in the city, because people look each other in the eyes, the speed changes, the understanding of people changes. And this change is comprehensive to such extent that everyone observes it during the last year or two. That's what I wanted to note. Thank you. And along with that, I would like to get back to the question of universal happiness per square meter. So Moscow is a large city, and people come to the center, which is the center of social life, this comfortable pedestrian center. But at the same time, we reduce the number of the parking lots, and including the Sadovaya Ring, and this limits the activity. This reduces the accessibility of small mobility people, of people with children. So, Alexander, please tell us, how do we solve this problem? Well, as for this program, well, nothing is ready yet. We're talking about prospects. But as for there is a decline of the number of parking lots, well, I always say that when an accident happens, but not with you, then it's not dangerous. But when we reduced by 30% the number of killed people in the accidents, so we reduced the number of killed people by 30%. So that's another indicator and another feeling when the price of life. We don't have the methodical indicator now because the cost of life, well, there's a question to the Minister of Transportation, and that's quite a comprehensive method, a method to estimate the value of life. There are American methods where the World Health Organizations estimate the life from 1 million euro. But as for us, this estimation is not ready yet, but we had a 30% decline of the killed people, and we have one-way streets with over 200 parking lots, and in the adjacent streets this the situation is the same. And in the streets that have excess number of lines, they have the parking lot not on the pavement but along the pavement. So it's a complicated process, it's a conflict process, but the figures speak for themselves.
I have a small comment. I would like to say it clearly. This policy, parking policy, is very balanced, but unfortunately it is violated by state authorities. We need to pay attention to that. I can bring you two examples. Bolshaya Dmitrovka is violated by the Council of Federation and the prosecutor's office. And if we take the bicycle lane along the Gogolevsky Boulevard, it is always violated by police cars. So we would like publicity to follow such examples and violations, because if there are norms and standards, and if they are enhanced, established, then they're established for everyone. And there are some actions on behalf of law enforcement agencies which are not to the benefit of the city. For example, the number of overpasses. Everyone tries to combat this, but the Federal Security Service doesn't give permission to eliminate them. So these issues need to be raised as well. And following violations, of course, special agencies are to follow them. But of course, our department has elaborated the app, which is called Active Moscovite. And any active citizen can be involved in the life of the city. And the Moscovite can make a photo of the car which violated the rule and its number. And this photo is sent to the special department. And the decision is taken, and this work has been done for Moscovites, but I think we will expand this for other cities. We had the same situation in Rome, where active citizen of Rome has sent the photo of the car of the police head who parked in an inappropriate place, which was only for disabled people. And so that police head isn't attending any international conferences since then. So thank you. Thank you very much for this timely remark, for this historic anecdote. And making conclusion of our discussion, I'd like to say that the increase of the number of happiness per square meter, thank you, Olga, for such a wonderful metaphor, is not only up to the urban development services, but for the Moscovites as well. Thank you very much, dear experts, dear guests. I hope that we will increase the number of happiness in Moscow in the future.